Make a date with Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwe at 6 a.m. from Monday to Saturday on Graphic Online via Facebook and YouTube as he expounds on matters of faith.
Graphic Online, truth and accuracy every day.
Hello. This is Reverend Dr. Ebenezer Markwe of Living Streams International, bringing you Matters of Faith with Graphic Online. This morning, I'd like to capture my thoughts with a funny title, Fear, I beg you. Fear, I beg you. I'm not saying you should fear, I beg you, but rather, I beg you that come out of fear. Now, there was one time, there was an interesting time, I invited a very powerful preacher with a powerful healing ministry to church. And, you know, as he was ministering, then he called one person who had a very brittle bone disease, a very dangerous disease. And he called another person who was, I think, blind or so. And, you know, when he called the person forward, I mean, there was a hush in the whole church. And a great auditorium, and there was a hush in the whole church, and everybody was like quiet. And I must admit, I was saying in myself quietly, oh boy, God, you show up here, or we all scatter. You know, and then something interesting happened. Some of the protocol people who were sitting behind us, our protocol, like the pastoral protocol people, one of them opened the mouth, and in prayer, she said, oh God, as for this one, God, please, whatever it is, please, God, show up, God, this one, as for this one, as for this one, God, please don't fail. And you know, one of the things that I just burst out laughing. I mean, I couldn't help but laugh. It was like, well, she was articulating what was in me that I didn't have the mouth to express. But she was saying it, but God, as for this one, please, you can fail in any other thing. You can bomb in any other thing that's towards me. But this one, God, please, don't make a mistake. You need to show up. And, you know, I sat down quietly. The interesting thing is that this guy prayed, the brittle bone disease never appeared anymore. And the guy was okay. I mean, it was a miracle. We saw the miracle. The blind person too, we saw the miracle. This is not go back and no. It was just there. And even the parents of the brittle bone disease patient said to me, from that time onwards, that 1-2 breaking up of bones, hospital and all those things, that was the end. You know what? Then I'm sitting back there and I said, okay. Now she was praying and I was praying. But you realize that, listen, we were not praying out of boldness. We're not praying out of faith, but we're praying out of fear and we're praying out of anxiety. We're praying out of fear and not out of faith. And that was it. Oh God, as for this one, dear, please don't fail. No. This is exactly what happened at the Red Sea. Moses and the people come to the Red Sea. When they come to the Red Sea, the people start crying out to God, and Moses also cried out to God. And then God didn't say to Moses, listen, I've heard your prayer. He just asked Moses a simple question. What is that in your hand? So what he was saying is, Moses, I don't need your prayer. I need your action. I don't need your call. I need your comportment, and I need you to study your head and study your mind and do what I've taught you. Listen, back at the backside of the desert, I showed you what your rod could do. All throughout your sojourn in Egypt, when you were your second coming to Egypt, I demonstrated with power what my rod can do. I demonstrated with power what my rod can do. So you listen, Moses, whether you like it or not, whether this thing, I've given you something. So instead of praying, act. Oh boy. Are you aware that sometimes our prayer is more out of fear than, you know, the fear of what will happen. The fear of what will happen rather than faith in God. You can pray out of fear, or you can pray out of faith. He who must come to God must first believe that he is, as a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Look here. God is still on the throne. Refuse to pray out of fear. Pray out of faith. See you later.